The UK Dementia Research Institute was set up to bring together a number of centres across the UK. These centres work together on a shared mission to advance the research, treatments and diagnostics of people living with neurodegenerative conditions. In our centre at King's, we're studying the molecular causes and looking for treatments of motor neuron disease and frontotemporal dementia. These are generally incurable diseases, so it's really important to understand the key pathways involved. So we have 7 research teams, which include 58 researchers, 35 students, and 4 clinicians, who collaborate very closely with the wide research environment at King's and across the DRI centres in UK. So the key molecular point that connects motor neuron disease and frontotemporal dementia is production of new proteins. And that's the expertise of our centre. We can understand at the molecular level where in the cells the proteins are produced, what are the stimuli that controls that, and how that can go wrong when these proteins have mutations that lead to diseases. So we've also identified many ways how to correct that. Many therapeutic approaches that can rebalance the process in spite of the disease-causing mutations. So we're connecting all that expertise. Some of it comes from computation, some from bioengineering, some from cellular models. But altogether, I believe we have that kind of transformative capacity to speed up the progress.
So the kind of science we do now in neurodegeneration is very complex and generates data that is huge. And that is exactly where statistics, computational science, but also things like machine learning can come in to capture those complex relationships and interactions in ways which we can't capture with very simple, straightforward, old-fashioned methods. So we're at the cusp, I think, of some really exciting discoveries because both the technologies have evolved to a degree where we can profile proteins, RNA, epigenetics in individual cells in ways which were not possible in the past. So I think I'm quite hopeful that in the next years, decades, we'll make some huge advances in the field.
The wall building where we work is actually about a 3-minute walk to King's College Hospital. This means that our scientists are able to connect with patients that much more quickly. It really does make this whole idea of, what is it, bench to bedside, really come to life. We have a growing base of international researchers, whether that's new students coming in or new staff, new scientists starting new projects. It's growing every day. There's all kinds of opportunities for learning here, whether you're staff or a researcher or a student. So the combination of world-class facilities, excellent research, cutting-edge techniques and technology, that's what attracts people to our center.
Due to the combination of expertise that we have built, we can make neurons from human stem cells, use bioengineering to look at these projections of these neurons, imaging to study the dynamics of various molecular processes in these cells, systems biology to deal with large data sets that we can produce, and even AI to predict the disease process. And by communicating across our centers, we are now speeding up progress because of the shared insight and shared technologies and treatments that can be applied across these diseases. So I believe we have a great opportunity in our center to transform the treatments and improve the lives of patients with neurodegenerative conditions.